Okay. So let's start to do that. Let's look at the indirect method for preparing cash flows from operating activities. Okay? Now, we're going to go to this illustration right here, and this is going to be the guide of what we're going to do today. All right? What we're going to do is we're going to start with our net income. We're going to do some things to it, and we're going to change that, in essence, to a number that is called cash flows from operating activities. All right? Now, stay on this screen while I talk, but I'm going to ask you a question. I'm going to ask you two questions. The first one should be really easy. The second one might require a little thought, but give me these answers. Okay? What financial statement do we pull net income from? This should be an easy question. The income statement. Okay? The income statement. Okay? That's where we get net income. Now I'm going to ask you another question. And some students, they have trouble with this. And then as soon as I talk to them, they're like, oh, yeah, yeah, okay, I knew that. Okay. Net income, yes, you are correct. It is found on the income statement. We prepare the income statement under which method of accounting? The accrual basis or the cash flow basis? The accrual basis, yes. We prepare the income statement on the accrual basis of accounting. That's why we have the revenue recognition principle, the matching principle, and all those sort of things. So we are starting with a net income number that comes off the income statement, which is prepared using the accrual method of accounting. What we are going to do is we are going to do three things to that number. Okay? And we are, in essence, going to transform that number from a net income based on the accrual basis to, in a way, net income if we would have used the cash basis of accounting. Does that make sense? Let me say that again. We're going to start with a net income number from the income statement, and that is prepared using the accrual basis. We're going to do three things to that number, or three sets of changes. And in essence, we're going to turn that number into a new number that basically represents net income if we would have used the cash basis of accounting. Does that make sense? Okay? Hang with me. I'll show you how to do this. The first thing that we are going to do is we are going to add back our non-cash expenses. Okay? Now, let me go to the doc cam real quick. Let's say we have an income statement, all right? And we know how income statements look. You have your revenues, right? And then you got some sort of total out there. And then you have your expenses out there, right? And then you have your total expenses, and then you arrive at some sort of net income number, right? Hopefully you made money. Let's say it's $100,000, okay? By the way, if I'm ever writing it, it's not on the screen. Just say, move it up, okay? Well, let's say one of those expenses is depreciation expense. Let's say we had depreciation expense of $2,000. That was one of our expenses. Now, that expense was deducted in arriving at our net income of $100,000, was it not? Do you see that? That was one expense that was deducted in arriving at this net income of $100,000. But is depreciation expense, is that a cash flow? Do we have cash leave us for depreciation expense? Can you trace that $2,000 depreciation expense to a check that was written? No. Depreciation expense is one of those expenses that we call a non-cash expense. Yes, in the accrual method, it is deducted in arriving at net income, but there's no cash outflow. Okay? So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to add back our non-cash expenses. Not all our expenses, just our non-cash expenses. Okay? So what we would do is this. We would take our net income of $100,000 and we would add back depreciation expense of $2,000 in that example. Does that make sense? We're going to add back our non-cash expenses. Now, there are four non-cash expenses. Okay? One of them is depreciation. Do you know what the other three are?
Amortization.
What?
Amortization.
Depreciation. Amortization.
Depletion.
Very good. Depletion. Aren't these all kind of basically the same thing? They're the spreading out of expense of a long-term asset. Depreciation are plant assets. Depletion are natural resources. Amortization are intangible assets. These expenses are deducted in arriving at net income on an accrual-based income statement. But there's no cash that's flowing out, so we have to add those back. Does this make sense? There's one more non-cash expense, and that is bad debt expense. Do you remember when we use the allowance method and we estimate bad debt expense? Well, there's no cash outflow that comes from that. So basically what we have to do, folks, is you start with your net income amount and add back your non-cash expenses. That is the first set. That is the first set of steps that we're going to do, is add back our non-cash expenses. What if you have rent expense? Do you add it back? No, because it is not a non-cash expense. It was deducted in arriving at net income, and we want it to be. Okay? Now, I'm going to stop right there, and we are going to do something real quick here. And for you folks at home, I want you to have this worksheet and do it as well. Okay? I might have shorted you one. If I did, hold on, I'll bring you one in a second. Okay? Now, let's take a look at this. This is the worksheet I want everybody to work on. I want to show you what I want you to do. This says, use the following information, and each case is separate, to calculate the cash flows from operating activities. Use the indirect method. Okay. Let's just do number one together. Now, I want to show you how I want you to do it, and then I'm going to show you how I don't want you to do it. Net income is $500 and depreciation expense is $39. So you can do this in your head. What is the cash flows from operating activity number? It is $539, but I don't want you just to put $539 there. What I want you to do is say, okay, net income is $500, and then we are going to add back depreciation expense of how much? $39, okay? So, I don't want you just to give me that. I don't even want you just to give me that. I want you to give me the whole kit and caboodle. Because if you write this out like I'm asking you to, without you knowing it, I am starting to teach, I'm teaching you how to prepare a cash flow statement, okay? And cash flow statements, just like balance sheets or income statements, they don't just have a bunch of numbers. They have numbers and titles and things we add up and everything. So what I want you to do is write this in the format. I just want you to do 1 through 5, okay? Just 1 through 5. Don't go to 6 and beyond. Okay, so do number 1 through 5. They're going to play some music. You folks who are watching this, you do it as well. Okay, number 1 through 5 on this handout.